thing that limits us would be limiting beliefs that keeps us in a certain place. Like, for example, if you're an employee, it's hard to be a business person.
Mm.
It's so hard to start an endeavor because you're an employee. You're shortchanging your employer. That's actually wrong. That's a limiting belief.
All right, this is part two of our video. In the first video, we talked about mutual funds and how they're an amazing tool for you to grow your portfolio over a stretched period of time. Now, you have a book. It's actually a national bookstore bestseller, no? And it's nice to hear and see authors who would create finance books that become bestsellers. Because the best-selling books are normally
entertainment
books, and you don't see finance books take the helm and become relevant. I know that the term trailblazing success came from a car reference, and also firing at all cylinders is also a car reference as well. Can you tell us more about it, and how can people make their finances actually fire in every cylinder out there?
Okay, I use that as a, people know I love cars. I mean, let's start with that. People know I love cars. So I use the car as a metaphor for investing, for managing, and for leading in life. The usual thing that comes to mind when we're getting into a better, faster track means making that shift. That's why people are saying from entrepreneurship, from employment to entrepreneurship, we make that big shift. So it's almost like you're shifting as you rise or you accelerate. That is a transmission metaphor. My metaphor for firing on all cylinders is the engine. A Ferrari can have 12 cylinders. But if you fire from 4 cylinders, that means it's going to move like a Vios. Right? So guys, we're all blessed by our creator with a lot of gifts. And we can fire from more cylinders. The thing that limits us would be limiting beliefs that keeps us in a certain place. Like, for example, if you're an employee, it's hard to be a business person.
Mm.
It's so hard to start an endeavor because you're an employee. You're shortchanging your employer. That's actually wrong. That's a limiting belief. If you're employed, you can give your company its worth by performing more and delivering more than what is expected. That means you're performing, you're worth more than your salary. Second, if you disclose, I don't think there's anything wrong with that. You ask permission. And if you're allowed to do your business, you're emancipated. You can do it. You can have a wife, you can have a partner to do the day-to-day, and you can have the weekends to work on it and build that base. So you can actually be an entrepreneur and an employee at the same time and do well at it. Now, the thing that I've done, and I guess this is the reason why I'm coming from experience, is not that I only did those two. I've been an investor all the way. I have invested not just in stocks, not just in financial securities, but I've also invested in the businesses of other friends. So I now have a slew of, or a portfolio, if you mind, of companies that are listed, companies that are unlisted, and they're all performing for me. So I'm an investor. I was an employee. I was a corporate executive, and somehow I did well there. But I'm a business person. So this is what I shared in firing on all cylinders, that people can fire on all cylinders. It's not that you're going to be fixed on a certain, you know, endeavor, and you're locked up with that. And there are excuses like, I don't have the capital, I don't know how to run that business, or maybe I'm not good at it, I don't have the experience. All of these things are just in your head. Why don't you contest them? Why don't you learn? Why don't you start building capital? Why don't you start dabbling into what you're interested in and start momentum? You know, I always believe that when you push momentum, you'll never stop and you'll never go back.
Here's what's interesting. Of course, majority of the people watching this are probably employed. How will they know that, hey, I'm not just for employment, I have some something entrepreneurial inside of me that I can actually be an entrepreneur? And how will they know also na, yata pang entrepreneurship, I just have to be a good employee, then save and live frugally, and then invest that? Is there parang a, in your experience, a point on where they can determine from themselves to know that I'm not really cut out to be an entrepreneur?
Okay. There are people who are like that. I mean, there's nothing wrong with being an employee all your life and becoming a good employee and somebody who will be working up the ranks and becoming good at it. There's nothing really wrong with that. However, there are people who will have the extra time, other mm-hmm. people who feel that they have extra gifts mm-hmm. that they can give to the world, like in terms of service, in terms of product. So why don't you unleash it? If it's there, if the desire is there, why don't you try it out? And again, many people are, you know, pulled to this because of, you know, some material reward that goes with it. No, it's not even the material reward. Sometimes mm-hmm. it's your way of like expressing yourself. Some people mm-hmm. can bake really well. Mm-hmm. And some friends would really say, oh, you have a great cake. So why don't we put this as a business? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Why don't we start selling? Mm-hmm. You know, you have the internet now. Mm-hmm. You have communities where mm-hmm. you can have as markets. So you can actually do try them out. So once you get yourself into another endeavor, you now become of greater value. And I'll tell you, there are people who don't do this because of that big excuse that they don't have the time. How much of time wasters do we all have? How much time do you waste on social media without
Netflix alone?
Exactly.
To follow on that naman, if you're an entrepreneur, the biggest, I guess, thing that entrepreneurs think of, no, if I have this extra cash, I'll just double down on my business eh. Parang putting this into marketing will give me a larger yield than putting it an investment that will give me 20% rate of return. Parang they get a larger buck for every buck that they place, they get a larger return. When can they say that? Maybe it's time to shift some of it into an investment that's far from my business.
Okay, let me tell you. There's not even a time for that. You should do that from the very start. The last thing you want is to put all your eggs in one basket. Mm. While that is very, very lucrative, you are going to be at risk. Mm-hmm. Because not all businesses flourish forever. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Like, yes, it's earning a lot mm-hmm. now. What if there's a big market change? What if a certain calamity hits your business? Where are you going to get the extra money? That is why you have to have other businesses, other placements, other portfolios mm-hmm. that match up with this. Not only because something wrong can happen. Let's just say nothing wrong happens and all your money is here. Can you retire? Remember, you have to have money set out on your own if you retire, because the business, you're going to pass that on to new owners or your children. Do you want to be, you know, at the mercy of your children for the money you want to spend for traveling, to enjoy your life? Because a lot of people do that. They build businesses, all their money is into it, they cannot retire because everything is in there. I mean, that personal checking account is the corporate checking account, right? You have to have money out of that business so that when you pass it on, you give the real reins to your children and you now have money on your own that you enjoy, right? Because this is the reason why the baton is not passed in many companies that well. Because I don't want my child to control the company. All my money is there. Mm. But see, if you have your own money and you're comfortable with it, you let your child manage it. There is such a thing as freedom as far as he can, you know, muster to take that company to the next level. Mm-hmm. But if all of your eggs are in one basket, you're not going to let go. Mm-hmm. So it's always very important that we have a base of money for ourselves that's not attached to our businesses. Mm.
Last question. I saw an article that there are 38,000 Filipino dollar millionaires already, and that's said to double in the next 5 years. If you are a Filipino right now that's just planning and starting out, over the next 5 years, what do you suggest? What are any trends, any waves that they can actually ride on, either investing or in businesses that can actually kickstart them, that they should look into this industry or this sector first, or this business, they should actually try that first, or invest in this property, in the stock?
Okay, I'm not a particular fan of any, you know, any business or any security. As I always mention, it's always space to have all of them. No? But let's face it, the future is all about technology. Mm. It's about service. So I'm going to be putting like my view on people's thrust towards technology and service and how they can make a difference to other people and make better lives. Mm-hmm. So even in stocks, like, you know, we're favorites of consumer, right? Because that's where, I mean, we have a demographic variable that we have to capitalize on. So there are a lot of people to serve. So consumer staples, consumers, consumer companies will do very well. Now, technology companies will do well either. You will do well also, but very importantly, you just have to make your right selections. But again, at the end of the day, if you want to be that dollar millionaire, if you talk to all of those dollar millionaires, they went and stuck with the basics, and then they built up on it gradually. Many of those are like that. A few of those got lucky. And even the people who got lucky will tell you, they did not depend on luck. They did what it takes. You know, some people can sometimes always think about doing what they love. No. As far as I'm concerned, I look back at my trap. Mm-hmm. There were a lot of times I did what I don't love. But I did what it takes. And that's what took me to where I am today. So please, do what it takes and then make sure you accomplish what you want to accomplish and reach your goals and dreams.
So where can people get Trailblazing Success and Firing on All Cylinders?
These two books are they're distributed by Kerygma Books. They're in all the feasts of Brother Bo, but they're also available in National Bookstore. They're also available in Power Books and in other bookstores. But National Bookstore is where to take it. Now, very important I say this and share this, Marvin. Not a single centavo goes to me. All the benefits for the author, every single, you know, cent of profit that goes in there goes to the Mercy Ministries of Brother Bo. Anawim, He Cares Foundation, Grace to Be Born, and other names. So it's my way of giving back, sharing relevant information, relevant experiences. But buying my books, it's an opportunity to also make a relevant contribution.
And it's a way for people to, for me not to learn, because when people ask me what business they should start, is if they don't have an idea what to start yet, they should invest in themselves. Because the fact that you're asking what business to start is, you don't know yet what to start it. And the best way to do it is to build your skills. And the way you get to build your skills, because people will pay you for the amount of skills that you give in the marketplace and the value that you place there. And it will start by just building yourself up. And you will only go as high as what you put in here as well. So, highly recommended book.
Again, very important, Marvin, is to start something. Because, again, it's a game of momentum. If you want to start a business but you don't act on it, you never create momentum. And if you're still, it will never happen. Now, Marvin's correct. You pick up a book, you talk to a friend who's in the business, you start building momentum. You know, investing in yourself starts spending in something already. So you have this idea. If you don't continue and if you don't proceed, you have lost something. Mm-hmm. So building up that momentum, creating that skill, you know, building up on your capabilities starts a ball rolling. So you better do it now. And you know why? When that ball continuously rolls, it will never roll back. So you're now into your way to starting your own endeavor, creating your business. And I hope, you know, one day it will be an empire.
And just to end, what I've realized is this. People are scared that, what if I throw everything I got into this business or this endeavor? What if it doesn't do well? What I've realized is, if it doesn't do well, that thing will lead to the thing that will make you successful also. It will be, because no one really knows if it will be good or bad or how it will turn out. But the skills, the experience that you will get from either that failure or success will lead to be something that will make you successful even later on as well.
It is not a real failure. Again, guys, it's a matter of perspective. Is it a failure or was it a lesson?
Mm-hmm.
As I've said, if it's a lesson, then that perspective tells you that success story is just another year, another few months on the backside. You just continue rolling.
Wow, so amazing words of wisdom again. So again, if you want to get a copy of the book, National Bookstore, if you want to know more about Ramfer and invest in mutual funds, the link is down below. And I hope this video helps you trade well, trade strong, trade smart. See you all again soon, guys. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Thank you so much.